We had an interesting casting challenge in that it was a movie written about one character, the fictional character, the centerpiece of the movie, who's in every scene, every frame of the movie. But we also knew that we wanted to see him perform. He's a musician. We wanted it to be about that, the movie to be about that, you know, performance, about an artist. We wanted to see him actually perform songs, and not snippets of songs, but, you know, performing at length. So we wanted to, you know, we were looking for a suitable actor and a credible musician, which is hard to find in combination. We just met Oscar, you know, at the point where we were kind of despairing, because that's a, you know, that's a hard thing to find, even in isolation, those two things, an actor that you like for the part and a musician that you find compelling. And we thought, we were starting to think, well, you know, that person might not exist, the one person, the performer who can give us both of those things. And we just met, as you do, you know, actors in auditioning, in the audition process, and Oscar walked in the door, and we just kind of heaved a sigh of relief and thought, okay, there you go.
So it was must have been a couple years ago, or I don't remember when, but I read something on one of the trades that the Coens were going to be doing a movie about the folk scene in the 60s, and immediately, because I've been a huge fan of Coens for forever, since I was watching movies, so and also a love for music and folk music, so I immediately then I was like, oh, that's it right there, I need to be a part of that. So I let you know, I let the people, my reps, know about that, and I was like, let me know what's going on about that. And so finally the time came to that they were auditioning and seeing people. And so I was able to get in for an audition. I met Ellen, I was a casting director, and I came in for her and did a couple of the scenes, and then went home and recorded Hang Me, which is the Van Ronk version of an old folk song that they were having, I think, a lot of people sing and put on tape. And I did that. I recorded it, spent like 4 hours recording it, 4 or 5 hours, just did like 30 different versions of it until I finally felt like, okay, this one's decent, and sent it in, and then the Coens saw that and asked me to come in for an audition for them. And I came in, and just in case, I learned a couple other of Dave's songs. I learned Dink's song and a couple other ones. And did the scenes and played a couple songs, and then it was great. It felt really good in the room, and then they said they'd let me know. And then a month later, I got after a month of agonizing over whether I was going to get it and screaming out to the universe, give me this! I finally got the call. Joel called me, which was a great way to find out, which was really just kind of goes to his personality and just how kind he is, and said that they wanted to do the movie with me.
Yeah?
Hey, it's me, Loon.
Yeah?
Can I come up?
No.
What's its name?
I don't know.
It's the Gorfine's cat.
It slipped out and I don't have the key.
If I had wings, I'd know where it's done.
If the music's not
fly. What? The river. Quit? Just to exist?
Well, fare thee well.
Mel, there was no advance on my solo record. There's gotta be some royalty. Mel? Mel!
How you doing, kid?
I remember one evening.
Don't tell him, Jim. Pouring
rain.
Oh. Obviously.
In my heart was an aching.
Do you ever think about the future at all?
Fare thee well, my honey. Fare thee well.
Folk singer with a cat.
Every time you play a C major, he'd puke a hairball.
Show us a bird flying high above.
I'm interested in gigging here.
Play me something from Inside Llewyn Davis.
Okay.
honey, fare thee well.